How's it going, everybody? This is RBT coming at you with week 14 of my Florida Gators NCAA 14 Dynasty Series. And this is going to be the last game of the regular season. We take on the Florida State Seminoles. And if we win this game, we'll be undefeated going into the SEC Championship game, which will be against the Alabama Crimson Tide. That's pretty much set in stone. And real quick before the game started, I'm going to show you the stats. Jeff Driscoll is actually 5th in the country in passing yards, rushing leader. Matt Jones is 56th in the country. Andre DeBose is 92nd in the country, tackle leaders. Morrison is 8th in the country, and he's been out for about 5 straight weeks, so that's insane. And sack leaders, interceptions, whatever. And let's get into the game. Florida State is 7-4, so it's going to be a tough game still. Now the record isn't insane, but, I mean, a rivalry game, playing at the Swamp, it's going to be a tough matchup nonetheless. This has national championship implications. Florida State wants to knock their rival off from winning the national championship or going to the national championship, so they're going to bring their all this game. So we have to be ready for Florida State's best. And we're going to go with the orange out here. Apparently they do not have orange socks. Let's go with black shoes. And there we go. Let's get this game rolling. And as always, before you watch the rest of the video, please leave a like. Cause I put a lot of effort into making these videos. And hey, if this is the first video you've seen them on, leave a subscription. Subscribe to my channel so you will not miss any of my videos. I promise you will not regret it. And let's try to hit about 20 likes in this video for the last regular season episode or game in this series. Well, for this first season, that is. And hopefully, after 2 more games, we have the championship game, and then hopefully, the national championship. Okay, guys, I totally apologize that I just kind of got sidetracked. Because, there was cops up and down my road earlier, about 30 minutes ago. I was shining the spotlight on the, all up and down the road, and I've been hearing some gunshots, and I just heard gunshots in my backyard. That's kind of a good reason to stop making a video, and I went and looked, and it's nothing's going on anymore, but don't know what happened. It's kind of scary, so if I die, I'd like to apologize because this video will never get uploaded. Alright, so with that out of the way, hopefully I will not get killed during the video, but let's try to get that off my mind and talk more about this game. We have the Florida rivalry between Florida State and Florida. Number 2 Florida taking on Florida State, who's looking to upset Florida and take them out of the national championship race. So the coin toss will be won by us. So we're going to go ahead and receive. And as the offensive coordinator, I'm not going to let our offense lay a dud this game. We're going to come out striking early and show Florida State they have no chance in this ball game. Let's hit them with a deep pass first. Let's go out of pistol, twin tight end set. We'll go with play action, deep, play action, power O. More than likely gonna hit the tight end on the out route here. And let's just see. Maybe DeBose will be open over the middle. Kelvin Taylor, or Taylor, and yep, wide open. And we got Thompson, Colin Thompson for the 17-yard reception. We're going to keep the bone rolling and hurry up offense. And let's get some yards. Let's keep the pace going. And score quick. Let's get these jitters out of the way early on. Little screen pass here. Oh, no. Aw, didn't get the block, man. There was nowhere going there. So now we got to slow it down. There was nothing going there. Watching the replay. And I had to kind of slow down because I could have got past that guy, but 72 could not get out to block number 20. Alright, so let's go out of shotgun, slot offset, do a read option here. If there is one, I'm pretty sure this one out of this formation, I guess not. So let's go with this mesh route. Man, I wonder why there's not an option out of that formation. Ball on their own 40. Okay, I'm not liking Dunbar's route here, so we'll just call a simple curl. He's gonna be open. Oh no! Okay, oh, he dropped it! Gosh dang it! Oh man, that corner bit. He got in really quick. That was a, is that LaMarcus Joyner? He's quick. That's for sure. Go with empty spread. middle slant. I want to see if that's Joyner. Is that? It won't tell me. We'll find out sooner or later. Alright, so we're looking for... Alright, the safety's in, so Thompson, I think, will be open. No, he's not. B's open. Yes! No! Alright, so we're doing this. We're going to keep the ball rolling. It's a rivalry game. We're going to set the tone early. If we can't get 1 yard, we should not win the game.
They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Oh, I'm not liking this out of this formation, though. Alright, have that counter here. I know this is not a good play. Not your ideal play, but hey, we don't have the right personnel on the field. But it's my only way as the offensive coordinator can go for it on fourth down. And we're going to get it. No problem. Matt Jones, spin move. Sick, let's go. Nice 13-yard game with Matt Jones. Let's keep the bone rolling. Keep it going. Keep the ball on the ground. We'll run a speed option to the right. See if these linebackers are as fast as they are told to be. Oh, where's your block at, man? God, that is LaMarcus Joyner. Wow, look at this. He has all the space in the world to go, but he just gets right off that block. Wow, that was a horrible blocking job on number one on the outside there. That's horrible. Let's try a little screen pass here, see if this can get anything going. Alright, so either have Burton to the left, or the Bose to the right. Ooh, man. Where's the blocking at, man? God. Apparently, we cannot block. 75's just sitting there, just chilling. For no reason. That pretty much has screwed this drive up. Hopefully, we can get something here out of empty quads. Man, let's go to the slot pivot route here.
And this play is number 8.
But we're
going to
send... Ooh.
Quarterback all okay. By himself in the backfield with 5 wide outs.
What can we send Y on? Send Y on a... Not liking that. Okay, that's fine. Oh, B's wide open. Can we get there? Yes, Andre DeBose. Perfect, baby. They're running a cover two. And perfect route. Got right off her press. Or maybe they weren't running a cover two. Were they? I think they might have. I'm not sure, but he got off her press, that's for sure. Let's run this bunch quad formation. And let's just run. I don't know. Not too many plays out of this formation of my custom playbook. Need to add some more in there. Alright, so I'm locking this little dragger out here, looking for Pittman, probably. Wide open! There's a zone! Oh, can he get there? LaTroy Pittman! Oh, down to the 2. Alright, let's keep this going. Looking at the Iron Bowl score at the bottom. Okay, let's go with the QB draw. Let's see if Driscoll can get it up the middle. Can he do it? Can Driscoll do it? QB draw their space. Bounce to the... Aww. Look at Jeff Driscoll's stats for the season. 182 of 266, 2,940 yards, 18 touchdowns. Didn't say how many interceptions. Okay, so let's see what... Oh, Will Muschamp wants us to do. That sounds... I like that read option here. I like the sound of that.
It's second down.
All right, we have Trey Burton in the back for this. Makes it even more awesome. He bites in. Can he get there? Oh, Driscoll was stuffed. Oh, I thought he had it, and he was stuffed. Number 24 came up and popped him. Luckily, he's not hurt there. You know what? Jeff Driscoll's a player. Let's go with the QB sneak right in the middle. We got this, Driscoll. You're a player. You're in the race for the Heisman. You can do it. Show your rivals where their place is. Up the middle. Ooh! Flipped over with the TD, so just like that, Florida takes a 7-0 lead. Methodical drive, 12 plays, 74 yards. Great drive there. Defense comes up big. And you know what? Let's get their juices flowing, and let's just kill their motivation with a nice play-action pass here. Let's get a quick touchdown.
I'm sure that touchdown
and just completely demotivate that Florida State defense and Florida State team as a whole. But oh wait, we have Trey Burton at quarterback by accident. Alright. Nobody open. Run, Burton. One. Oh, shoestring tackle missed. Juke. Okay, nice. You know what? Let's keep Burton in here and run the football. Let's see if we can get some big plays with him. I haven't really played him at quarterback lately. But, oh, I like this halfback direct play. I haven't ran it much this season. Let's see. Man, that's where... I mean, you're not going to get any yards if the tackle just comes through unblocked. Like, 76 didn't even, like, hit him at all. Well, that was a failed play. He had space, but, you know, can't do nothing when that happens. When the AI does not block. I like the full house formation. Let's try this triple option here. It's a pretty nice play. You can either hand it off Taylor or run it with Driscoll or toss it back to Matt Jones. Oh, Kelvin Taylor! Let's go, baby! Third and inches. Let's keep the bone rolling. That was a great play there by Kelvin Taylor. Nice, good vision. Nice read by Jeff Driscoll. And let's keep it going. Up the middle with Matt Jones. Can he get it? No, wow! Missed block by the corner. Wow. Controller died. Oh, what the heck? We're going for it. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. But we're going for it, guys. We are going for it. Oh, scared. Put Dunbar on it. Okay. I gotta be feeling about this, guys. Wide open. Give me that. Oh, no. Wow, he was wide open. What is wrong with my controller? Oh, my gosh, guys. Wow. We could have blocked for just another split second. Why can't you throw the ball right here? Wide open. That's a TD all day. Wow. Okay, so missed opportunity there. So, man. 53-yard field goal good by Florida State. Wow. Okay. Missed opportunity by us, and the defense at least held them from getting the momentum completely back and held them to a field goal, so that's okay, I guess. The post off a press again. Can he get it? Oh, bad pass picked off by Brutus. Horrible pass by Jeff Driscoll. Bad decision. Knocks him out of bounds. That's the first turnover of the game. Bad pass, bad decision by Jeff Driscoll. Wow. And Florida State takes the lead. Okay, guys, so we need to keep our heads in here. We're okay. Only down by three. We're going to be okay. Play action pass here to Thompson, more than likely. He's always open on the corner route. Oh, and he was covered there, so we dump it off to Kent Taylor. 2 yard gain, nothing special. Wow, that's been pretty much a 14 point swing, actually. Okay, so we're on a little middle slant here. Ball on the 27 yard line. All right, so all the momentum swing has gone the other way. Maybe DeVos can get open here. Wide open is RB, and that's Pittman, LaTroy Pittman. Oh, that was a great play because the safety either had to follow the guy running the post route, the skinny post, or DeVos going downfield. He covered DeVos, so Jeff Driscoll hit LaTroy Pittman over the middle on the skinny post for the huge gain. So good play there. We're running a little power O. Keep their defense guessing out of the I formation. Goal line set pretty much. Power versus power. Oh, and block is the outside. Matt Jones cuts in. Big play. 14-yard rush. Let's keep this power formation going. That's why I like my offense that I run as offensive coordinator. Because you can spread the ball out, but just like that, you can come back in and just put a hat on a hat, block downfield, hit them in the mouth, and just block and get good gains like that. So we can run to the opposite side here. Missed block by Trey Burton, and he gets only 1 yard. Okay. Oh, there was nobody there. The block, really. Okay, so let's hit him with a read option here. At least we're in field goal range and potentially can tie the game here, but we're going for the lead. We're not selling for a tie because we got to win. Number two team in the country. We have a big hole here. Driscoll to the inside. Can he keep muscling it? He gets about 14 yards up the 5 yard line. Great play there. Great blocking overall. Going to run that same play again and hopefully muscle this one in for the Jeff Driscoll's second rushing touchdown of the game. Depends on what the defensive end, if he crashes or contains. He crashes once again. There's a flag on the field. Touchdown, Driscoll. Wait, let's see the flag. And it is offsides. Offsides on the defense. Offsides on the defense, Mario Edwards, penalties declined, that is a touchdown. Jeff Driscoll with a 5-yard TD run, great play, Another good drive, and Florida State marches right down the field and takes the lead again. The defense is not playing so well. 17-14, Florida State over Florida. All right, guys, so we have to come strong, and we don't want to be losing coming into halftime or going into halftime because Florida State gets the ball back, so we're not able to stop them thus far. X is wide open. Oh, drop pass by Dunbar. It was put into a little area, but you got to make those catches if you want to compete on a national stage. All right, so read option here. See if we can get going. Not liking what that outside linebacker is doing. We'll keep it anyway. Hands it up the middle of Matt Jones. Linebacker wasn't fast enough to hit Jones over the middle. Or hit him before he hit the hole over the middle. So we got to hurry up. Third and two. We don't need to keep running the football. What was I calling there? All right, let's call it inside smash here. Just get a first down at least. Call Dunbar on an out, a deep route. And he gets past. Oh, bad pass again by Driscoll. He's really trusting his arm too much. Oh, fumble, pick it up. Oh, man. Second turnover of the game by Jess Driscoll. Oh, man, bad play. And Florida State doesn't score, but they do score coming into halftime, or coming out of the half with a field goal. So, wasn't a terrible, terrible turnover, but doesn't really help when you're trying to take the lead. Let's try to hit him with the screen pass here. See if we can get going. Keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel right, any anxiety so about trailing. We don't need to trust Dunbar unless he's wide open, and he's not. Oh, they're blitzing it outside, guys. Matt Jones. Wow, that's a crap I don't understand. A running back getting chased down by a defensive end. All right, makes sense, guys. They must put some juice in there, guys. Their guys' milk. Pre-game meal. All right, so still sticker out here. Hopefully the Bosa will be open. He's not. Looking. X wide open down the middle of the field. Dunbar, big play down to about the 48-yard line. 23-yard reception by the big guy, Quentin Dunbar. Let's hurry things up here. And we will call a... Let's go with that halfback mid-draw. See what Matt Jones or Trey Burton can do up the middle. Can he get the outside block? Good block there. Trey Burton rumbling, tumbling for about 9 yards. Let's keep it going. Two rushes for 21 yards already for Trey Burton. Let's keep it going on the ground with old Burton. Read option here. I like this. I like it. Read options have been working for us. We're going to keep it going. He contains, and Burton has a big hole up the middle. And another big 9-yard gain by Trey Burton. So I'm liking this formation here, this personnel. It's working. It's already 3 carries for 30 yards for Driscoll, or for Trey Burton. Let's keep it going. He crashes in. Misses the block. Wow. It all happened because the wide receiver missed the block. Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has a... Instead of going for the inside guy, he goes and runs and blocks him in the linebacker. Okay. Don't know what our wide receiver coach teaches our wide receivers and how to block. On their blocking scheme, okay. Ball on the 37. Alright, deep pass here. Do we trust Driscoll? Make sure the dude has to be wide open. All the room in the world for Driscoll. Couldn't get the first down. He jukes in. He's going. Driscoll down to the 10-yard line. 27-yard scramble by Jeff Driscoll. And we're going to keep the bone rolling. 74, 46 yards rushing on 7 carries for Driscoll. We'll go with the read option to the weak side. See what we can get going. I'm not liking this, but let's try it anyway. They both crash in. Oh, juke move. Oh, touchdown, Driscoll. His third rushing touchdown of the game. Let's go. We'll pin the extra point. We'll take a 1-point lead. That's 21-20. Defense comes up big, and we get excellent field possession. So field position on our 49-yard line. Awesome, awesome. All right, same personnel that was working out last game. The last drive crashes in. Can we get another big game? We do. Can he get the outside block? Driscoll, one tackle away from taking it to the house. 17 yards from the ground. That's one-third of Jeff Driscoll's carries have gone for touchdowns this game. And you know what? You got to do whatever works. The running game is working right now, so let's keep it rolling. Contains in, and Trey Burton gets the ball. for a nice decent three-yard gain. But hey, we're in field position. Just no turnovers here. Let's keep it going. Let's keep the ball on the ground. Let's go with the halfback mid draw. All right. Trey Burton, can he get? Oh man, did not pick the right hole. But hey, let's keep the clock going. And let's keep the pace going. And let's run a. Let's see if we can get him a blitz with a halfback screen. Let's kind of try to center the ball here on the screen as well. All right, they're blitzing. This should be a first down. Oh, Burton. Oh, God. Dang it, man. There's four blockers right there. Can you please show a replay? I want to watch a replay myself. See, that's what I don't understand. You see, Driscoll. Okay, the screen set up perfectly. There's three guys right there to their one. Yet, they don't even try to block him. And does not get the first down. Alright, so hopefully that doesn't really cost us. Bad decision, bad blocking scheme assignment by our O-lineman. And we get the field goal, and Florida State answers with a field goal of their own. So you know what? Let's go for a deep pass here. Play action, so counter, waggle. Only up by one, so this game, like expected, is going down to the wire. Rivalry game, big time atmospheres. Nice play fake. Wide open. Ooh, thrown into coverage. Jeff Driscoll didn't have the arm to make that throw, obviously. So going into the fourth quarter, guys. Florida leads Florida State 24-23. They're a quarter away from either heaven or a quarter away from moving forward to their goal of the national championship or getting their dreams crushed and losing the chance to go to the national championship. All right, so big drive here. Let's call a screen pass, and maybe the offensive line will actually block correctly here. And let's send the tight. Let's see if we get them all to the right side and see if we get the Bosa slant in. Move everybody to the outside. And it works! No! All right, big third and 10 here, guys. This is a very, very big play. Let's go out with a pistol formation. Getting nervous here. Four wide receiver set. I'm liking, let's see. Play action deep in. I don't know if I'm going to play action. Let's just run verticals. Let's just trust a deep play and maybe we can get a big gain here. We're playing press if we can get. DeBose wide open. Did he get his feet in? He does, I think. Let's hurry it up so they do not review the play before the booth. Oh. They're reviewing the play, guys. This is such a huge call. Such a huge call. Does DeBose get his feet in? Oh. No, he does not. So more than likely, the play is going to be overturned. Wow. And we're going to have to rely on defense. Can the defense come up big? Let's see. Oh, yes. Good stop by our defense, and we get the ball back with 3 minutes remaining. So let's try to move the ball and milk the clock at the same time. So we're going to turn tempo to conservative and big run to conservative while trying to gain some yards, hopefully. All right, so Matt Jones, Jeff Driscoll to personnel. He bites in. Oh, safety, big play, but Driscoll with an excellent. Oh, no, don't hurry up, please. Oh, gosh, did I click? Why? No. Okay, good. No. Oh, God. All right. So that sucks. Did not mean to do that. We'll just run a simple halfback dive here. And sorry, I'm going to let the clock run to... We're going to let it go down all the way. So I'll pick it right back up whenever it gets to like 5 seconds. I'll start talking again. All right, here we go. Second and two. Up the middle. Can we get big first? What? What? You're kidding me. You're kidding me. You are kidding me. Horrible execution on our part. Can't even hand the ball off on a simple halfback draw on a third and one. Wow. That, wow. I don't even know what to say about that. Let's All right, so huge play here. The Heisman contender, Jeff Driscoll, the junior, relies in his hands on a big play, third and seven, the biggest play of the season thus far. Nobody open. Oh, and he gets pulled down for the sack. Okay, he was trying to scramble forward and didn't get anything. Can the defense come up big? Okay, guys. 29-24, a minute left, national championship on the line. This is not good, guys. A touchdown wins it. A turnover probably loses it. Trey Burton in the game, not what I wanted. Okay, and he gets a ton of yards, baby. Let's go. Get out of bounds. All right, we need to get new personnel. All right, that's a mistake by me as the offensive coordinator calling the personnel with Trey Burton in there at quarterback, and we do not need that to be the case right now. Okay, so let's be safe here. Go with Weeks pistol here. Plays that we know that'll work. Let's go out a full house here. And I don't know what they're running, guys. We got 19 seconds, gotta hurry. Play action power up, I guess. I don't know. We don't really want to get sacked here. This is a big drive, guys. Alright, looking for Colin Thompson to the outside. Ooh, I'm not trusting myself. Okay. That's better than a pick. We want to be very careful with what we throw here. Alright. Alright, what are we going to do, guys? Shotgun. Let's go with this deep attack here. No mistakes, though. No mistakes. From their own 49-yard line. Second down. With the Dunbar on the outside. Don't trust your arm. Just run up the middle. Oh, nice juice move. Alright, hurry up, Driscoll. We need to save these three timeouts in case we don't score. Alright, 54 seconds left. Big play here. Let's just go ahead and call four verticals here. Better hurry up, guys. Hurry up. Over the... Oh, there we go, baby. Matt Jones. Clutch over the middle. Yes! We get down to at the 30-yard line. Okay, guys. So, 40 seconds left in the game from about the, what is it, 30-yard line. I'm not even sure myself. We'll keep the deep pass going. 40 seconds left, all three timeouts going, so we want to be safe here. Quentin Dunbar to the outside. Looking for him. Nobody open. Oh, Driscoll goes to the outside. Has all the room in the world. And he gets down to about the 10-yard line. Knocked out of bounds about the 13. Yes. He avoided the sack. Huge play. As we see here, the replay, number 15. Or number 8 got right through the tackle, defensive tackle. Lunged for it and missed Driscoll. And that was a big mistake as he got down to about the 10-yard line. So about over the 13-yard line, that is. So let's be safe here, and we'll call, you know what, we can call what's been working all game. And that's been the read option. I'm going to get it to work. It's been working all games. Why is it not going to work now? And we'll keep the hurry up going, too. We won't use our timeouts. Up the middle, Kelvin Taylor to the outside. 28 seconds left. All right, second and five. All right, we're going to run the same. Oh, can we hurry up, guys? Can we hurry up? All right, read option again. 20 seconds left in the game. We have all three timeouts, so time really isn't a factor here. Up the middle, Kelvin Taylor to the outside. Oh, did not get the first down. Third and inches. Okay. All right, so big play here, guys. Third and inches. National championship on the line. And you know what? It's been working all game. Why not go to it again? It's been working all game long. Third and inches. 13 seconds left. National championship on the line. Up the middle, Matt Jones. Touchdown, Florida. Touchdown, Florida. Florida takes the 30-29 lead. Nate, we should be going for 2 points to make it a... Oh, no, we should not. Yes, we should. I don't even know. Yes, we should be going for two to make it a field goal game. And we are. Okay. So what does coach wants to do? We'll go with a half eight. I don't know. Let's go with the H stick here. Big play. 10 seconds left. This will provide a lot of cushion. Jeff Driscoll to the outside. He got the room for the 2-point conversion. So Florida's up by 3 points. Has a field goal lead with 10 seconds left. And Florida gets the W and goes into the SEC championship game undefeated and remains in the national championship hunt. So one game remains between Florida and the national championship as they pull out a squeaker against arch rival Florida State. It takes a huge drive by the junior Heisman candidate Jeff Driscoll to get the W. The freshman Jameis Winston came so close to getting the biggest win of his career, but you see Jeff Driscoll had the best game through the air, but gets three touchdowns on the ground. Just provided and just played great and led the team down in the game-winning drive. Scored with 13 seconds left. Matt Jones up the middle for the W and got the two-point conversion. So Florida pulls it out of their butt in a tough game, 32-29. You got to leave a like for that, guys. We're going to the national championship. We're going to do it. We have to beat Alabama next week. Let's see game stats real quick. Man, that was awesome. As you see, 12-21, 144. No touchdowns and two picks. Got sacked one time. 14 carries, 102 yards for Driscoll. Matt Jones had only 31 yards, but had the biggest play of the game with that last rushing touchdown to give Florida the lead. Trey Burton also a big game. 6 carries for 53 yards. And also the freshman Kelvin Taylor had a couple big runs for 21 yards. Receiving, you had Matt Jones led the team with 3 receptions. Troy Pittman led the team in yardage with 57 yards, but no touchdown receiving. No receiving touchdowns that game. Moved the defense side of the football. And I'm guessing Antonio Morrison still isn't in the game. He's still injured, I suppose. And, alright, we need to see player stats for Florida State real quick. See how Jameis Winston did. Big game by him. 20-36, 241 yards, 3 touchdowns. Also added 41 yards in the ground. Devontae Freeman, 59 yards. And look at Rashad Green, 138 yards. It's a pretty big game by Rashad Green. And defensively, LaMarcus Joyner led them. I think I mentioned him a couple times early on, making some big plays for Florida State. As you see, we led. We gained them in total offense by 10 yards, doubled them really in rushing yards. And as you see, what made it close was the turnover differential, minus 2 for Florida, but they still find a way to get the win, 529 yards to 403, and penalties not too different, and time of possession pretty even there. All right, so. Just to make sure, we're going to exit the game, and we'll go into the SEC Championship Week, and I guess it'll be a little bonus here. People that watch to the end of the video will be able to see, I believe, who won the Heisman. And maybe it's going to be Jeff Driscoll coming off that pretty good performance, that clutch performance nonetheless, had a big game on the ground, but not necessarily through the air. But hey, if you're a winner, you're a winner. That's all that matters. You win anyway. We'll take any win. All right, we'll continue. Advance week will be a bye week and then to the SEC Conference Championship. Okay, so we will go ahead and send to the Conference Championship. Hopefully you guys will not really get bothered here, and I'll cut the video right here and we'll wait until it gets sim until the Conference Championship Week. So catch you guys in just a second. And here we go, everybody. It should be over. And here we show you the recruiting real quick. A couple of recruits lock us out. We're in a recruiting battle with a couple guys. Donald Berry, Charles Owens, and Josh Locke will continue. And there we go. We did make it to the SEC Championship game. So nonetheless, it's been a successful first season. Continue, but we still have that SEC Championship game and National Championship game on our mind. And yes, we'll take on the number 6 Alabama Crimson Tide, your number 2 versus number 6. And if Florida doesn't win, that'll be the first year in the last 7 or 8 that the SEC team has not represented and or won the National Championship game. So, but we got to take things one game at a time. This is a huge game, taking on number 6 Alabama. It'll be a tough win. Probably the best team in the country that they get beat by a good Texas A&M team early on in the season. And quickly, we'll show you the top 25 poll. Oh, we did not get to see who won the Heisman, actually. And as you see, it's Braxton Miller, Jeff Driscoll, Jordan Lynch at Northern Illinois, Derek Carr, Fresno State, and Blake Bella, Oklahoma. You'll have to see who gets the W. And I guess I want to see a top 25 poll myself here and see what's going on. So I guess it's a little bonus for you guys. I thought the Heisman was going to be shown, but I guess not. Well, the four teams in the national championship hunt are Texas, Florida, Nebraska, Fresno State. So pretty much the only hope for these two teams is that I lose this game against Alabama. And if Nebraska, the only hope for Fresno State is that Florida and Nebraska lose this, because Texas is set in stone, because they're lucky because they do not have a conference championship game. So they actually, their closest game of the season was against, I think, Ole Miss or BYU or Ole Miss. Ohio, wow, they had a bunch of 10-point games. BYU, Ole Miss, Iowa State, Oklahoma, and a bunch of blowouts there. So that's kind of surprising. See how Fresno State did this season. Their toughest game was against Rutgers. They blew out Boise, and that's about it. Toughest game. Nevada? Yep. Nevada. Oh, yeah. Or Colorado. Wow, they battled tough against Colorado. Okay, so I guess that's it. Oh, I did want to check out Jeff Driscoll's season stats so far. Hopefully you guys will not hate it that it's going to be going this long. I see Trey Burton 17-20 in the season. Tyler Murphy's not thrown an incompletion yet this season. As you see, Jeff Driscoll 188-288, 3,017 yards, 18 touchdowns, 17 interceptions. So a lot. He is turnover prone, through a bunch of picks this season, but hey, he's still undefeated, so that's all that matters. 67% completion percentage and 17 quarterback sacks, which isn't that bad. Running the football, Matt Jones leading the team 833 yards. Jeff Driscoll second, and on the team 595 yards. Trey Burton, Kelvin Taylor, Kyler Murphy, and Matt Brown. And Jeff Driscoll leading the team with 18 rushing touchdowns. Receiving, the Seahawks leading the team Andre DeBose, Quentin Dunbar, Marcus Robinson, and I'm wondering what is going on with Antonio Morrison. I want to see if he's still injured, because this has been a lingering injury all season long. He should be back by now, but I don't know what's going on. Wow, he is still questionable. He's been questionable for the last two or three, maybe 4 weeks, so hopefully this game he'll be back, but we'll have to see. So I'll cut it here, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Please leave a like if you did, and make sure you tune in next week for the SEC Championship game against the Alabama Crimson Tide. And as always, Roll Tide, go Sox, and go Titan Steve. Have a great day. I am RBT. Be sure to follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/S3RTR. Peace.